What's good, everybody on YouTube? It's your boy, OG, big homie Rara.
Lord knows I want that all tomorrow, but I ain't rich yet. Truth be told, I hit your home.
All right, y'all. I told y'all I wasn't gonna stop. You feel me? Till we on the top. You know what I mean? So this is another video. You know what I'm saying? OG back. I'm trying to bring y'all videos I have not seen on YouTube because I told y'all I'm doing this thing a whole lot different than everybody else. So this is a video I'm surprised I've not seen on YouTube, but I haven't seen it. So I'm giving it to y'all. A lot of people probably think this is common knowledge, but a lot of people need this. You feel me? This is the fastest way to get your badges, your playmaking badges in the park. I'm going to do playmaking. I'm going to do shooting. I'm going to do defense. Y'all can comment below what y'all want next. You know what I'm saying? But around this time of year, everybody's either making lockdowns or they're making playmakers so they can get ankle breakers. So I showed y'all my lockdown build. Now I'm about to show y'all the best playmaking badges. I mean, how to get your playmaking badges the fastest, you feel me? So a lot of people think you should know this, or most people won't even try coming out to the park without their badges. I'm not going to lie to you. I'm tired of my career. So when I come out here now, I got to have, you know what I'm saying? I got to be going straight to the park if I come out here with a new player. And I've been making some new players lately, and I have not played any my career. You do need my career to get gym rat, but you got to be in the mood to play my career, and I haven't been in the mood. So I'm about to show y'all how to get these playmaking badges. I'm going to show y'all the best badge setup when you starting off. Everything A to Z, you feel me? So number one tip, if you getting playmaking badges in the park, the easiest way to do it is lobs, period. Like it's so easy to get playmaking badges by doing lobs. It's hard when you go out there with somebody you don't know. Like if you out here with randoms, it's hard. But like if you get them to catch on that you trying to throw lobs, randoms love to get lobs. Because everybody wins off lobs. You get finishing badges off lobs fast, and you get playmaking badges off lobs fast. So the first badge you would probably need is bronze lob city. After you get it bronze, you honestly do not need it anything higher. Sometimes when I put it higher, it makes the person that I'm passing it to miss even more. So I'll put that on bronze. Needle Threader Hall of Fame is your next badge. You need that for whenever you're making any kind of pass, but especially lobs, because once people catch on to you're trying to throw lobs, then they're going to start sitting in the paint. If you have Needle Threader, that can help you out. You feel me? Next, diamond. All right, everybody wants, you know what I'm saying, the lob, but sometimes it's not there, and you got to throw diamond. You know what I'm saying? You might have a lockdown on your team or a slasher on your team, and they need this diamond to boost their shot, so that they can knock it down. You can open the paint back up, and then you can get your lobs off. You feel me? Facts. So this is the three I started off with, the three badges when I went to the park. You can even, like, you can take this down, and you can put it on, like, if you out there with people you know, you can put it on, where is it? Flashy Passer. Like, that's going to give you a lot. Flashy badges give you a lot. But those are risky unless you had this badge on. So, I mean, really the way is Needle Threader and Lob City. So, I would probably go just like this. This is how I would upgrade my badge. Bronze, Hall of Fame, Hall of Fame, Hall of Fame. Even though I just told y'all that doesn't work sometimes. I mean, for people who aren't like slashing builds, it helps them a lot. But slashing builds, I feel like it throws them off a little bit. And then, I mean, after that, you can put on Flashy Bastard if you're really trying to get all your badges. But at this point, you got enough badges to do whatever you need to do. You feel what I'm saying? So, I'm going to get into some gameplay and show y'all me doing it. I can't just tell y'all, you know what I'm saying? I got some comments last video. People saying they want to see my build in action. You feel what I'm saying? And I didn't show y'all any gameplay, but that was because I was saving it for a future video, you know what I'm saying? When I max my boy out, I'll show y'all how Jimmy Butler out there moving. But let me get into this gameplay. All right, so I ain't gonna keep y'all too long. I'm just gonna show y'all one or two clips. You feel what I'm saying? It's me out here in the park, you feel me, with my boy Schemebo. Shout out to my boy Schemebo, always holding it down. He definitely one of the reasons I got all my slashing badges on this build. Probably the biggest reason I got all my slashing badges on this build. And then he helped me get all my playmaking badges too, because he know how to cut crazy. A GOAT at this junk, you feel me? If you catch Schemebo in the park, don't step on the spot. So Pete, you feel me? My boy, this is not even a slashing build, but he just know how to cut. Like, if you out here with somebody, it's too easy to get your badges. But if you out here dolo, I'm not gonna lie, it is kind of hard for you. But you can get it, bro. Like, eventually a random will catch on. But you can see, like, we just trying to get my badges. We just trying to get his badges. He was trying to get his finishing badges. This ain't even a finishing build. And then I was trying to get my playmaking badges. But, like, I mean, you can make anything possible with your badges, you feel me? Like, I got most of my badges on this build. I think I have Floor General and Hall of Fame on this build now. And I don't even think I have Lob City Pass on my jump now. But I'm still able to throw lobs. Like, actually, I don't know if I have it on or not. Let me see if it come up in the clip. So, I only got Lob City on my player. Like, I don't have Lob City on him at all. One thing you don't want to do is try to force a alley-oop or a flashy pass. Like, whatever you can get off, get it. Like, anything helps, you feel what I'm saying? But I just know he gonna cut every time, and it's easy to get. Like, sometimes you're not gonna get it because he's not a finishing build, but it's easy to get, you know what I'm saying? It's easy to get your oops if you have a player. You see that just jumping in the lane now, so they trying to stop him from doing it. That's what Needle Thread is for, you feel me? And Lob City Passer too, you know what I'm saying? That'll make him catch it. But if he had Lob City Finisher on, he probably would have got it. Just easy. I'm telling y'all, it's easy. I'm showing y'all it's easy, you know what I'm saying? So y'all see how to do it, you feel me? It ain't no secret formula. I'm just showing y'all. Now let me show y'all how much I get for it. So, like, I showed y'all what we doing, you know what I'm saying? He didn't want to cut that time. I guess he felt like they was in the paint. But, like, you can see, like, I'm not playing with y'all. Like, I got 8 assists this game, doing nothing but passing. Probably about to get a crazy amount of points. I haven't even watched this clip. I just seen that I had 8 assists in it. So, I was just like, I'm going to put this one on. So, y'all can see, like, I'm not playing with y'all. Like, you can get... just off of any type of assist, you can get a whole bunch of... Yeah, I know I'm about to get a bunch of playmaking off of this. Look, got like 8,000 playmaking, and that's also like a 15-minute game. You can play the part. Look, alley-oop assists, 5 of them, got 6,000. Regular assists, you got 500. Outlet passes, you get 980 off 2 of them. Like, you can get a crazy amount of this and not even be doing anything. Like, if you was playing in my career, you not getting 8,000. Playmaking off 15 minutes. You're not doing it. It's not possible. Unless you playing on Hall of Fame, you playing on 4-5 minute quarters, and you just passing it the whole time. Not doing anything else. So, like, it's low-key, definitely the part's funner than my career, and then this is, it's low-key easier if you got somebody out there that know what they doing. So that's the video, man. Thank y'all for watching. You know what I'm saying? Comment, subscribe. Anything y'all want me to do in the future videos, just let me know. You feel me? Y'all want to see D-Wade come out here? You know y'all got a sneak peek of him right now. If y'all want to see D-Wade come out here, let me know. If y'all trying to see Jimmy Butler, my peer lockdown, come out here, let me know. I read all my comments, so please like, comment, subscribe. We going up. We did amazing on my last video for a comeback. You feel me? We're going to do amazing on this video because I haven't seen this on YouTube, period. We going up, man. We going crazy, you feel me? I read every single comment, so please comment, even if it's not even about the video. I think somebody said they heard my thing need a battery change. You probably hear it in the video, but you know what I'm saying? This your boy. We genuine, you feel me? It's your boy, OG. Thank y'all for watching. Peace.